I am Marquese Scott. I was born in November 5th, 1981 in Inglewood, California. I was raised in Indianapolis, Indiana. I joined the military and I was stationed in California for 4 years in San Diego on USS Constellation. Then I decided to get out and continue dancing and further my career in Atlanta. I moved to Atlanta because my family had already moved there, so, and met up with a few other dancers that kind of showed me the technique and how to dance. I was already dancing before, but I didn't have structure and stuff, you know, so, and I kind of took that and made it my own and didn't really follow the guidelines like how you're supposed to, but I guess that's what differs me from everybody else when I dance. And I released a video about 6 months ago, Pumped Up Kicks. It's just another video that I uploaded on YouTube. Like, I used to upload videos all the time on YouTube, and that just happened to take off for what odd reason. And then woke up and it had like 2 million views. It was crazy. It has like 40 million views now and counting, so that is what started my success as a successful professional dancer as opposed to just a street or a club dancer. As soon as that video went viral, I called my agent and was like, yo, man, I got a lot of views on this video. And he was like, oh, yeah, come into my office, blah, blah, blah. And, like, I think 3 days later, I was on Ellen, at the Ellen show. And ever since then, like, I've been traveling the world. I had to get a passport expedited. Like, I ended up paying like $600 for a passport because I needed it so fast. And I was going overseas. I went to China, Japan. I went to UK, Mexico. Like, now I'm in Portugal. I go to Spain in a week. I go to Canada. It's like, it's crazy. Like how much I'm traveling just because of a video I put on YouTube, you know? But I'm grateful though. What I did for a living before I made that video was I worked at Walmart, I worked at warehouses, I custom designed shoes, built houses with my uncle. Like, just the normal stuff a normal person would do, you know, like trying to make it, trying to shuffle careers, you know, like which one do I want to do more? And it was always dancing, because like I remember one night I was at Walmart working, and it was an overnight shift, so I had to go in about like 8 o'clock, and I heard there was a dance competition going on, and I was like, what? There's a dance competition? And I just left the job and like went to go to the competition, ended up quitting Walmart and just dancing, like. I'm in that zone, all I'm thinking about is the music. Like, I'm not thinking about anything else besides what beat is coming up next, you know? It may sound weird, but like that song E.T., you know what I'm saying? Like, it just takes you somewhere you've never been before. Like, you're no longer on Earth, you're like an extraterrestrial, you're an alien. You know, it doesn't matter what problems you're dealing with after you get done dancing or what you're dealing with before, because nothing else matters but that moment that you're dancing. So that's what I would say, it makes me feel. If I'm dancing to a song that I don't like or I don't connect with, then it will be, the dancing will not tell a story. It will more or less be, oh, he's dancing to the music. You know what I'm saying? As opposed to connecting an audience because everything I do is it relates to the song and how that song speaks to me and how I'm gonna project what I'm hearing from the music to the audience. It's like a portal almost. You know what I'm saying? So it just all comes out off the top of the head. My imagination is in the music.
Kicking.
As a person, like, people come up to me all the time, like, oh, you're famous, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, nah, I'm just a dancer, you know? I'm the same person I was before all those views, you know? So I don't see myself any different, really, than anybody else. The first thing you need to do is make sure you're signed, because you don't know who out there will take care of you the best, as that has your best interest at hand. Make sure you stay down to earth, because, like, people are gonna like you for who you are, and if you change into somebody else, they're not gonna like you anymore, and then you won't be as successful in your career as you would have been if you were being yourself, you know? So, and stay dedicated. Whatever it takes to get the job done, just do it. I actually had a conversation with one of my friends about imagining life without music. If there were no music in the world, it would be terrifying. No, I can't imagine a world without music. If I wasn't a dancer, I would probably still be in the military somewhere. I can't imagine it. It's like, if I wasn't a dancer, where would I be? I don't know. So I've been dancing like all my life, so it's kind of hard to say what I would be doing if I wasn't a dancer. Maybe an architect, maybe a chef. Open a dance studio. It's gonna be called Nonstop Studios. It's gonna be a 24-hour next level dance studio where a dancer can come at any hour of the night. Like say you're dealing with something at home, you wanna go and dance somewhere, you can come to the studio. You can do your bio, your resume, there's gonna be a gym there. There's gonna be like a section where you just go sit down, play video games, just chill out, you know? It'll be like a dancer's escape from the world, whatever they're going through. And still be able to maintain a career as a dancer there. definitely a blessing, you know. I've been doing this for 18 years. That's a long time. A lot of people would have gave up already. So I am lucky in a sense that I didn't give up and blessed that I'm still dancing at 30. You know what I'm saying? I'm very excited about this project we're working on with Nebula because I saw some of the references they showed me and their ideas and concepts. I haven't done anything like this before, so this is gonna be like, I think it's gonna have a good shot on YouTube of going viral if it's done right, and I'm pretty sure they can do it right. So I've seen some of their work, so this is gonna be awesome. It's gonna be, what I'm imagining is gonna be what it would feel like if you were inside the music. That's the kind of vision I have, like controlling the universe and everything around you is controlling. You're controlling everything around you. And when you're dancing, the music is talking to you and you're basically portraying the music through you. So then you're gonna see a different visual side of that. So if that makes sense to you, that's what I think it's gonna be dope though.